Yes.
Right, Aki Karim here for BBTV. I'm joined all the way from Germany today by Emmanuel Odesai, who is a big heavyweight prospect in his own right. But importantly for this fight week, Anthony Joshua, one of Anthony Joshua's sparring partners in general. Firstly, how are you keeping, sir?
I'm good. Thank you very much. How are you doing?
I'm all right. I'm good. I'm excited because I think as this comes to Saturday night, it's a really big fight week feel. You must be very excited about it as well, obviously being in the thick of the action.
Yeah, of course. I've been sparring AJ in March. It was meant to be for the preparation for the Fury fight. So I've seen how he works out, how he does his thing, and I'm looking forward to the fight, man. I'm excited.
Well, Emmanuel, last time I spoke to you, there was a potential of the Tyson Fury fight, and you were, you know, a big, tall, rangy guy who was helping Anthony out in that style. Obviously, he's fighting a southpaw, a smaller southpaw now. How important is it to get proper sparring and sparring that replicates your opponent when you're going into a big fight?
I mean, sparring is half of the rent. You got to have good sparring partners and proper sparring in preparation for a fight because you want to deliver on fight night. You want to be ready. You don't want to be surprised by nothing that your opponent brings. So if you can bring in sparring partners that can do different kinds of stuff that your opponent does, you're ready, you're prepared. But sparring still is different than fight night. So it's just preparation for fight night, but you can't really, what's the right word? You can't really
imitate Alexander.
Replicate the real deal. Like, you can't really replicate Alexander Usyk because he's one hell of a fighter. Like, I don't even know, like, more than 200 amateur fights, I think. Olympic gold medalist. One hell of a fighter. So it's going to be a tough fight, but I think Anthony is ready for it. He's mentally very strong. He knows what he needs to do. And he's been there before, like fighting Olympic champions, been in their stadium fights. And it's in London, man. I think it's going to help him. It's going to help him in a stadium again.
Yeah. Well, Emmanuel, you can give us the insider sort of, insight into this. You've spent time with Anthony Joshua closely in a camp, or not in a camp, but in a training environment. What makes him special in your opinion? Because I know you rate him extremely highly. What makes him special about the way he works?
I would say it's just the work ethic, man. He's very smart about boxing. Like, he tries to learn on a daily basis. Like, for example, there might be some champions who think, yeah, I'm a champion. I've done this and that. I've knocked this and that guy out. I'm ready for whatever comes. But AJ is different. So he knows he's a champion, but also he knows that because he didn't have big of an amateur pedigree, he needs to learn every day. So he wants to learn every day. And he's watching old throwback fighters. He's watching them every day, and he tries to implement stuff that he's seen on, like, YouTube or whatever, and tries to implement this in his training on a daily routine. And with the people he has around him, they're, like, always keeping him humble, just being straight up, like, being honest to him. And that's really important as well because it's a good environment. Like, everybody's humble, everybody's honest, and when things go wrong, they motivate each other, but they're being honest to each other. And it's very important because there's other camps in boxing where people are just saying what the champion wants to hear. And yeah, it's not positive. Yeah.
And as somebody who shared the ring with him, I know you're not going to give too much away, obviously, but do you feel that, do you really feel that championship caliber when you're in the ring with him? And can you sense that you're in there with somebody who's very well schooled, and has got a lot of strength. I mean, what's it like to be in the ring there with him?
I mean, he's got power. You can see it. You can see it in all of his fights, all of his pro fights. Physically, very strong. Like in the clinch, whatever, he's got a bunch of tricks. So he's very strong. He's doing a lot of like strength and conditioning work with his coach Jamie. So yeah, he's strong. He's fast. He's athletic, and he learns boxing on a daily basis. Like he learns new stuff. And he tries to perfect it. But I think it's going to be a hell of a fight because Anthony Joshua is a proper heavyweight. Alexander Usyk is a great boxer, but not a proper natural heavyweight. So he's more of a cruiserweight still. And I think this is the thing that's going to make the big difference in the fight because AJ is too strong.
Interesting. I mean, you're in Germany there. You've done a lot of your training in Germany, obviously. And, you know, he's got a lot of support. Alexander Usyk has got a lot of support in Germany, a lot of support. They love the guy. What makes the German public, but also what makes him so popular in that area, that part of the world as well?
I'd say it's maybe because we have a bunch of guys from Ukraine and from Russia. From Poland living here, so they can like what's the right word? They can relate to him because he speaks the language, like he speaks Russian, and yeah, he's a humble guy. He's a humble guy, Alexander Usyk. Like he don't brag too much. He's all about his business. Like he's doing his talking in the ring, and of course, like great amateur pedigree. And German boxing people, they like people with big amateur pedigrees. So Usyk is, he's great. I like him as well. Watching him fight, watching him train, it's very interesting. He's doing a bunch of like. Crazy stuff. A lot has to do with your brain and mentality. A lot of hand-eye coordination, like interesting stuff. So you can learn a lot from Alexander Usyk.
Oh, certainly, he's a class act. But it sounds to me like, are you predicting? You mentioned the strength and the size. Do you think then that eventually this fight's going to go the distance, or do you think Anthony Joshua might stop Usyk? What's your actual prediction for the outcome of the fight?
Well, my prediction is Anthony Joshua stops Usyk because he's too powerful. But even if the fight goes over the rounds, I wouldn't say Usyk beats Joshua on points because that would be a prediction that many people would say if it goes over the rounds. But I feel like the way Joshua is working on his boxing and just staying composed and having confidence in his boxing, he could even outpoint Alexander Usyk because he's physically stronger, he's taller, and he's long. He knows how to use his reach, and he's quick, explosive. So, yeah, if he's fit, and I've seen pictures of him losing weight, being slim, being fit, it can go over 12 rounds, and AJ can even outpoint him. But just from what I think is the way AJ deals with southpaws, like, he can knock him out, and he will knock him out, I'm pretty sure.
Okay, we've heard the prediction there from Emmanuel Adesai. Now, Emmanuel, the first video we did together when you were in Manchester, it went down really well. Lots of people watching the video, and I think they were really interested in the way you spoke. You obviously, you speak great. Now, what they've been asking me is, when are we going to see Emmanuel in action? When can we see him? When's he going to fight? Tell us a bit more about your own career, man.
Yeah, so my own career's been kind of on the stumbling block because I haven't fought for years. Like COVID's been happening in like all over the world. Amateur boxing been stuck in Germany as well. So for my career, it's still up in the air, up in the clouds, what I'm going to do next. Obviously, I've been speaking to Pep, been speaking to the guys from Black Flesh Promotions. Maybe we can work things out in the future that I'm coming to the UK. He's going to build me up. Me going down the professional route, learning boxing that way, or I'm going to stay being an amateur, go down the amateur route, get my amateur experience in, and then fight at the Olympics, and afterwards turn pro. We're going to see. Still, I have time on my table. I'm 22. I'm not getting any younger, so it's going to have to happen soon, like the proper, the right decision. But I'm going to speak to my management team. I'm going to do the right decisions, God willing, and I'm going to be fighting back soon. I'm pretty sure. But it's not easy being an amateur fighter, preparing to fight, for example, let's say world championship qualifies, and then your fight gets called off. So yeah, I'm learning that side, that part of the business as well, which is like really hard, because it messes with your mental health as well, because you want to fight, you've been preparing, it's mentally drowning, but still I know this is boxing, this is part of the game, so it's just preparing me, making me stronger for once I'm in a professional ranks and once I'm fighting as a professional. So yeah, I'm ready. I'm staying healthy, I'm training, I have great sparring partners over here, but it's just about me being in the ring back soon. I'm gonna have to fight soon. And if it's going down a professional route, even though I still want to gain more amateur experience at the top level, but I'm not getting it, then I have to go down the professional route and learn boxing that way. I mean, some people have done it already, so I could do it as well. I'm very confident in myself. I know I'm going to be world champion one day, but it's just about making the right decisions. And right now, I got to make the right decision.
Yeah, well, you know, the future is very bright for you. Young man, hell of a lot of potential. Already sparred the likes of Joshua, the likes of Deontay Wilder. So you are really, really hot property in boxing right now. You've got to give everybody your handles, man. Tell everybody your social media handles.
Yeah, my social media, follow me on IG. It's Emmanuel Odiasa. That's basically it. I'm posting on IG. I don't have any Facebook at the moment where I'm promoting myself. So just follow me on IG. Once I'm in the UK, once I'm fighting in Manchester, you can all come watch me live in action. You might see something special. I'm looking forward. I'm looking forward to the future, man. I'm healthy, thank God. God bless everyone that's watching this video. God bless you, Aki.
Respect.
Thankful to speaking to you. Yeah, man.
Yeah, man. Oh, it's great speaking to you. I think people are going to love you, and especially if you come to Manchester, mate. Let us know, because we'll get everybody out here to come and watch the big man in action. 100%.
I'll let you guys know. God bless you.
God bless. Emmanuel, thank you so much for your time. We'll catch up with you again soon, and enjoy the rest of your evening, whatever you're doing.
You're welcome, bro. Take care. Thank you, bro.
Take care, my man.
Bye-bye.
See you later.
Take care, bye-bye. Bro.